the White God, the Black God, the Blue God, the Silver Key.
Okay, all right, that derailed really quickly. Welcome, one and all, fellow hunters, as we talk about the remaining two monsters that can not only challenge Elder Dragons, but dominate them. Two creatures of legend of utmost power. They are said to be the earthly incarnations of gods. One of fire and one of ice. They both don't play nice. That's the best I could think of. God damn. So, beginning with Ukanlos then. Oh, by the way, how do you feel about chins? Like, if I said to you, who's got the best chin? I mean, what would you come back to me with? I mean, we've got Captain Quark, you know, it's quite, looks like quite squishy, you know, like you want to just grab it, you know? It's not a bad chin. I mean, you've got, of course, this kid here. I mean, what the fuck? Like, his parents cannot love him, but, you know, it's a striking chin. You've got the crimson chin. I mean, that's like his power, right? Aragorn, don't even leave. But no. The champion of chins, Ukanlos. Look at that. It is a serrated shovel chin. Like, imagine being able to claim, yeah, baby, I got a serrated shovel chin that I use to dig through the snow along with my streamlined serrated body to move incredibly fast under the ice despite my huge size. Did I mention huge size? It's like, come on! And the sad thing is, that chin is the last thing you'll ever see before being hit by Ukanlos' most irritating and arguably devastating move. He loves to slowly undulate through the ice up down as he moves towards you. And this moment is terrifying because you're sprinting away. You're like, I don't want to die! And the timing for when you need to dive, it was bullshit, honestly. He got introduced in Monster Hunter Freedom Unite and has remained pretty much a champion of what the hell was that hitbox to this very day. So, when he would go under the ice and start swimming through it as if it was water, you see, he does strike an impressive figure, right? He's this tanky, turtly shark covered in serrated white plates that give him this streamlined appearance that really is quite intimidating. He is bulky, he is huge, and he just auras this power emanating from him. Though underneath, he's actually quite a softy because of a thick layer of blubber to survive the extreme cold like a whale. Further deep down than that, there is a heart of pure hatred. Like, his eyes glow with malice. Yeah, tiny little beady death eyes staring into your soul, covered with one of his ridge plates to protect them from the harsh weather, which is a rather nice little feature, because he only lives in extremely remote, cold environments. And by cold, I mean fucking freezing. He lives in the most arctic-y places he can damn find, carving out entire ice kingdoms for himself with a massive swath of territory of which he is incredibly aggressive and protective of. Woe betide anyone who enters the territory of an Ukanlos, because really, that's the last mistake you'll ever make. And this extends to monsters. I mean, on the dietary list of a Ukanlos, it's things like a Kirin. Yeah, you know, not bad. And, oh, I don't know, a Devil Joe? Yeah, these things are Nomon Devil Joe. Not Rajang, by the way. Just saying. Though that's probably a habitat issue more than anything. But he also likes to eat, you know, just herbivores. And then the final item on a typical Ukanlos menu is it Ukanlos or Ukanlos? I've never said these out loud until videos. But either way, the final item on his menu is a Kushaladora. Yep, he's totally fine with taking down and eating Doras that wander into his territory. So, yeah, that's That tells you what you need to know. And the thing is, that's what I love about him. He is not an Elder Dragon. He's not mystical, you know, there's not anything like, whoa, no force of nature about him. He is just a supremely powerful organism, expertly adapted to dominate his environment as a tip-top apex predator, and his power, strength, and fortitude allows him to take down a being that can summon tornadoes and storms like it ain't no thing. He's just a monstrously, perfectly evolved animal, and I can really get behind that. So yeah, Gianna, you think you're cool with the whole eating elders thing? Shh, ain't nobody as cool as Ukanlos. Because he lives in the ice. He can literally hibernate under the ice for years and years, which makes sense as an Arctic-based animal needs to be able to survive on low amounts of food and energy, because meals tend to be few and far between in such sparse wilderness. So that makes sense. So get wrecked, Nergigante. But thanks to this streamlined body that essentially he's just a walking snowplow everywhere, he can cut through the ice at incredible speed, swim through it as if it was nothing. For his size, he moves ridiculously fast, surprisingly so. So he chooses a hunter, swims through the ice towards them, homing in. The other three hunters, by the way, are just kind of watching, going,
yeah, good luck, have your time, you're dead.
You're fucking dead, mate.
And you're just like, come on, guys, please! As you sprint away from this homing attack, and you just have to choose the moment, right? It makes Diablos burrow dodging look like an absolute walk in the park, because this is haystack in a needle timing. I mean, that's impressive, putting a haystack in a needle, to be fair, but it was really irritating. Hell, there's loads of video guides on specifically dodging this attack, so that's the thing that, honestly, Ukanlos is best known for. But outside of that, he's a magnificent animal, incredibly rare and containing unmistakable, raw, furious power, originally mistaken for an Elder Dragon, as these powerful non-elders tend to be, but no, he indeed is not an Elder Dragon. He can also consume ice, buckets, that's tiny compared to him, lots of ice he eats, and he absorbs what nutrients he can. They help keep his body temperature regulated, and they also let him do his ridiculous ice beam attack. It is just this pure cutting through everything as it just tears the ground and hunters asunder. It is really quite scary when he starts firing off the ice beam, which gives him some lovely ranged ability. And lovely ranged ability goes further because he uses his shovel chin to dig into the ground and just fling boulders of crushing ice at his targets. His roar is just striking and awe-inspiring. He can even leap huge distances with his powerful legs. I really can't stress how agile this guy is for his size, and size is key here. For a non-Elder Dragon, he is one of the biggest monsters going, competing with only a handful for sheer bulk. But that bulk, combined with his speed and power, and his just perfect adaptation to where he lives, you can see why he's such a dominating force that people were like, yeah, this is probably the white god, right? This is definitely a god. God of jaws, perhaps. God, that jaw. That's it. I missed breaking it. Like, I really want to break that chin. Yeah, I really want to break that chin. Yeah, I couldn't resist. So, I admit I've been holding out on you a little bit here. So, Ukanlos then, that's essentially everything. He's just a really powerful, big, well-adapted to snow animal. However, what class of monster would you say that he is? He is a flying wyvern.
Whoa, what?
Yep, he's a flying wyvern. Flying wyvern.
I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away.
I I love that so much. I'll link the original comic that it's based off in the description, hopefully. But it's hilarious that he's a flying wyvern. And the thing is, he's part of a group of animals like Tigrex and Nagakuga, whose front legs, which in a normal wyvern are developed into wings, have developed back into more, well, actual forelimbs that are used, well, like legs for more powerful land-based travel. But he still technically has the tiniest little nub of wing on his front two legs. It's so tiny, but he's technically still classed as a flying wyvern. Tigrex is still technically a flying wyvern. There is the term pseudo-wyvern, but that's not a canon term, it's just created by the players of the game to distinguish the more ground-runny wyverns, but no, he is technically a flying wyvern, so enjoy knowing that. It's amazing. So yeah, let's go on then to his counterpart. So, Ukanlos is smooth and icy. Akantor is every bit as powerful, but he is spiky and fiery. I mean, really, I could end the video there, because it really is just a case of a fire-ice flip-flop. But let me introduce you actually to Gravios, a huge wyvern that has quite literally a rock-hard carapace. He is quite sizable. I've not fought him in so long, but he's quite irritating, to say the least, but he is capable of firing a huge magma beam that is decimating. He is a powerful creature, okay? And Gravios, then, is a morning snack for Ukanlos. He feeds on them constantly. So that gives you a starting idea of where this guy is going. Akantor, then, also a flying... flying wyvern, equally as capable of taking down elder dragons as Ukanlos.
Victory!
In fact, encounters other creatures a lot more than Ukanlos. Ukanlos likes to be more of a loner. Akantor has been sighted across multiple environments, including, actually, snowy ones. Can you imagine a battle between these two? It's even a common fear in the Monster Hunter world that if an Akantor and Ukanlos do meet, they would fight each other. They're both unbelievably aggressive predators, and the resultant fallout of that titanic clash, well, it would be devastating on the surrounding environs. You would have destruction cutting a swath through the land at an unprecedented scale. So the guild likes to keep tabs on these creatures and make sure they stay separate, and often hunting parties are sent out to really keep Akantors, especially as they like to roam, in check. But yeah, he likes to roam around the place and just destroy everything he comes across, so that means villages, monsters, people, hunters. It's given him the nickname in a lot of places, the Disaster. So, yeah. He is covered in these spines that shake when he roars and give him, well, anti-air defense, which I think is quite cool. His fangs can puncture rock, which is how he hunts Gravios. He's got one hell of a jaw strength, can shatter rock. His physical prowess is crazy. His spiky club tail will absolutely decimate you if it connects. He crushes you into the ground. He's got no kind of breath or beamy attacks, but what he does have is one hell of a pair of lungs. His lungs are so powerful that his roar shatters the ground around him because of the sheer force projected, and causes little bits of lava to erupt outwards. When he goes on his hind legs and bellows out his fury, casting the shadow of death across the battlefield, it is a sight to just stand there and be like, oh my god. You never forget your first Akantor. He can use his powerful roar to fire sonic-based attacks at you that absolutely shred. But more than that, he is just about the physical domination. He wants to dominate you physically with just powerful smashes, swipes, tails, just everything at his disposal, charging at you, burrowing underground, coming out with lava everywhere, able to swim through lava, burrow through rock. He is essentially immune to fire, at least canonically, and he is just terrifying. There's not a lot more to say about him. He really is just a Ukanlos, but fiery, but the black god, the disaster, Akantor, a terrifying, aggressive apex predator that will quite literally mow down everything in his path because he's just constantly having a really bad day and needs to take it out on the world. So there you go, guys. That is the Akantor and Ukanlos pair. They are very, very potent, huge, powerful animals, both flying wyverns, and able to take out elder dragons with almost contemptuous ease, at least the lower tier ones. So I hope you like this. I really do. And I hope that you share it around. It takes a lot of effort to make these. And if you did have fun, learn something, or just enjoy yourself, a like would be appreciated. Subscribe for more. And I will see you soon. A good boy.
Rage gaming with the video flow.
But that's all that's really relevant at the mo. But I'm still gonna leave this up so you patrons know that I love you even though the outro's no longer that kinda relevant. But the new one's being worked on and it's gonna be a truly badass song. And don't worry, I won't be doing any rapping on it. I'm gonna go now. This was shit.